We already know manual and mesh calibration of the print bed. Let's see how to automate this calibration and get the most out of the print bed calibration. Before we can fully dive into today's topic, I have to ask you to watch all the previous videos about print bed calibration. If you have not yet manually calibrated the print bed and set the print area, please do it now. It is important for the automatic print bed calibration. Before we begin, I would like to thank everyone who contributed to the existence of this YouTube channel. Mainly, I would like to thank my Patreons. Their trust in me is unreal. They are the ones who make sure that this YouTube channel exists in the future. If you want to be one of them, you can do so on the links in the description below the video. So, what is the automatic print bed calibration? In mesh bed leveling, we tell the printer how far the nozzle is from a print bed on a predefined point map in our firmware. Automatic calibration works essentially the same, except that it finds a print bed itself and, thanks to the parameters in the firmware, it can calculate the nozzle distance from the print bed. Automatic print bed calibration works with the help of a calibration sensor. This sensor can be a button, an inference sensor, an inductive sensor, and so on. There are many sensors and each is suitable for a different surface. Calibration then proceeds similar to mesh bed leveling. The printer performs standard homing on the X and Y axis, then it performs homing on the Z axis using the calibration sensor and uses the measured value as a reference point for following automatic calibration. The printer goes through all the points defined in our firmware and remembers how far from the Z-axis home position the sensor was when it was activated. These are the same values that we had to find and adjust using paper and moving the nozzle closer to the print bed at each point. In our firmware, the calibration sensor has defined distances from the nozzle in the X, Y, and Z-axis. This allows the printer to know exactly where the nozzle is when the sensor is activated. If you have previously used mesh bed leveling or another calibration sensor and changed the Z-probe offset, please set it back to zero. Be sure to update the firmware in your printer, retrieve new data from your firmware, and save the values back to EEPROM after reloading. This step is very important. This will prevent a lot of problems. I will show the settings on the Ender 3, and as the calibration sensor, we will choose the simplest and cheapest variant of automatic print bed calibration, which is button and stop. Yes, you hear correctly. Button and stop. Are you happy that you do not have to buy anything? Before you full of happiness, unscrew the end stop and stick it to the hot end. Try to look for a more civilized solution. Just a few minutes of searching and I found what I was looking for. I have printed the holder out of recycled PET from Czech company EcoMB and I thank them for this filament. Unfortunately, the holder was large and there was a gap between the parts. Therefore, I have printed several versions of the holder with modified dimensions. The best version was the one that was reduced to 96% in the Y-axis. It is very important that the holder can be inserted and removed without any problems. At the same time, the holder should not move freely. The rest of the filed parts went to sorted waste. The holder is printed, so we can install it. Be sure to let the printer cool down. Unplug the printer after it has cooled down. For Ender 3, just unscrew the screw, place the holder on the hot end cover, and screw the screw back. Now, remove the Z end stop holder and the Z end stop itself. Screw the button on the holder and try to insert both parts into each other. I guess you noticed that in our case the wires going from end stop to the motherboard are short. Therefore, we will extend these wires. There are many ways we can make the wires longer. We will talk about three ways. The first and the simplest method is to cut the wires, join them together and wrap them with the insulating tape to avoid contact with each other. The second method is like the first one, except that we will need more tools. The wires are soldered to each other and insulate it with heat shrink tubing. The last and the simplest method for SOVAN is to make a new cable without destroying the original one. I choose the method creating a new cable. Now we need to bring the cable prepared by us from the end stop back to the electronics box and plug in instead of the original end stop. I chose the method of using the same path that already leads cables from the hot end. After installing the hardware, you need to look at the software. In our case, the firmware. In our firmware, the calibration sensor has defined distances from the nozzle in the X, Y, and Z axis. If we know these parameters, we can write them into our firmware. Otherwise, we reach for the ruler and measure. If the sensor is to the left of the nozzle, in front of the nozzle, or below the nozzle, I write values in negative format. The sensor is 42 mm to the left of the nozzle, so I write minus 42 to the offset on the X axis. The sensor is 5 mm in front of the nozzle, so I write minus 5 to the offset on the Y axis. And the last one is the Z axis. Here you need to find the position where the sensor is activated. Then, remove the sensor and measure from this distance that the Z-axis must travel to touch the printbed with the nozzle. The Z-axis offset was approximately 4 mm. The value is minus 4, but we will write just minus 3 to the Z offset. Keep the remaining 1 mm as a reserve for subsequent calibration. Now we comment on the lines that we have commented on in the previous episodes and are no longer needed. In the configuration file, comment probe manually. This was like a manual sensor replacement. Next, comment on manual probe start Z, alias the default Z value for manual calibration. Since we will use a different type of calibration, we will comment on mesh bed leveling. The calibration shown in this video will run before each print, so we can comment on the restore leveling after G28 definition, which again enabled the calibration after homing if the calibration was turned on before the homing. And as the last in this file, we comment on the definition LCD bed leveling, which is used to start the calibration and save the calibration result using the LCD. In the configuration advanced file, we comment on the definition of baby step display total. That shows us the total number of baby steps since the last homing. Thanks to the new calibration method, we no longer need this. We will now augment the lines we will need for this type of automatic calibration. Open configuration file and uncomment fix mounted probe. This tells our firmware that our sensor is fixed or that we have to mount it itself. In other words, the printer is only interested in its status, not in its preparation for function. We will also uncomment Z safe homing to make the Z axis homing at the center of the print bed after homing the X and Y axis. Check that Z min probe uses Z min end stop pin is uncommented. This tells our firmware that our sensor is wired as a Z end stop. Next, check that EEPROM memory is enabled. To have this, we need the EEPROM settings definition uncommented. I recommend uncommenting the definition EEPROM auto init. This definition automatically initializes the EEPROM in case of an error. Now is the time to choose a calibration method. We have a choice of auto bed leveling 3-point, where you need to specify the X and Y coordinates of 3 arbitrary points on the bed that are not collinear. The result is a single tilted plane. This method is suitable for a flat print bed. Another method is auto bed leveling linear. This method is very similar to the previous method, except that this method does not use 3 fixed points. This method probes several points in a grid, You specify the rectangle and the density of sample point. The result is a single tilted plane, and this method is again suitable for a flat print bed. Another method is auto bed leveling bilinear. This method is again very similar to the previous method, except that the result of this method is a mesh. This method is suitable for large and uneven print bed. The next are auto bed leveling UBL, which is a combination of all the previous and mesh bed leveling that you already know. Mesh bed leveling is very similar to auto bed leveling bilinear, just this one is designed for devices without a calibration sensor and includes a step-by-step guide through the entire calibration process. We will use auto bed leveling bilinear. Now, let's move to the file configuration advanced, where we uncomment the definition for baby stepping. It is used to fine-tune the height of the first layer. Next, we uncomment the definition baby step Z probe offset, which combine baby stepping with the sensor Z offset that we set at the beginning. For easier access to baby stepping when tuning the first layer, we can uncomment double click for Z baby stepping. This allows us to open the first layer eye calibration by double clicking from the main screen. If we have a graphical display, we can uncomment baby step Z probe graphics overlay. Thanks to this, we will see a simple graphical interface when using baby stepping. The point map is defined by grid max point X and grid max point Y. By default, the map is set to 3 points on the x-axis and 3 points on the y-axis. This is sufficient for small areas below 250 to 250 and when printing on glass or mirror. However, it is always better to increase the number of points and thus increase the measurement accuracy. As you increase, try to choose between an odd number so that one measurement is always centered on the print bed. If it's necessary to limit the movement of the sensor on our print bed, we can do this by using the min probe edge definition, which limits how close the sensor can approach to the print bed edge. If we need to set specific limits, we can do it via left probe bed position, right probe bed position, front probe bed position, and back probe bed position. I also recommend increase the number of measurements at each point to at least 2 measurements by uncommenting multiple probing definition with the number 2. The speed of the first measurement is set via Z probe speed fast, where is used the default homing Z feed rate stored in the homing feed rate Z definition, which is 4 multiply 60. You can increase the speed of how you want, but always expect worse results at higher speeds, especially in the case of mechanical sensors. Once we are in this section, we can change the speed of the homing X and Y axis. This can be done via the definition homing feed rate XY, where we currently have a value 20 multiply 60. Again, you can increase the speed of how you want. The speed of the second and each subsequent measurement is set with Z probe speed slow. In our case, the speed is set to half the speed of the first measurement. We will slow this speed down to the third of the original speed. To prevent the sensor from hitting the glass holders used as a print bed, it is necessary to adjust the distance of the sensor from the print bed during calibration. First, we look at Z clearance between probes. This value tells us how high the sensor will be above the print bed when moving between calibration points. Start at 15 and try to decrease slowly until you find your safety distance. Always keep the distance a little bigger. Next, we have Z clearance multiprobe. This is the distance between the sensor and the print bed between measurements. 3 mm are perfect in our case. Z after probing tells us how far the sensor should be from the print bed after the calibration. In our case, I have chosen 20 mm as a safety distance. You can lower it if you want later. We can continue on Z-probe low point. This is a safety feature that will ensure that the calibration fails if the sensor is 2 mm below the lowest reading. Another security feature is Z-homing high. This tells us how much the Z-axis should be raised before the printer starts homing. With our type of sensor, it's better to be higher than lower. So let's set 20 mm. Since inserting and removing the end stop will take us a little while, and we don't want to get into the phase that the steppers deactivate and we move one axis, we will increase the default stepper deactive time from 120 seconds to 600 seconds. 10 minutes must be enough for everyone. We can ignore the other parameters for now. Now, we can try to build firmware for your motherboard. The motherboard of NDR3 uses microcontroller 80Mega1284P, which has only 128 kilobytes of flash memory, and this is very restrictive for our firmware. It will be necessary to disable some features of our firmware. If you have another motherboard, try to free up memory gradually. First, we comment out ARC support, which is mainly for CNC machines and useless for us. Next thing we turn off will be resume printing after a power failure by commenting out power loss recovery. Last, we uncomment slim LCD menus, which save us a lot of space, but we lose a lot of settings from the control menu. To make everything as in previous videos, we'll rename the printer via custom machine name in this video as well. The new name will be MyNDR3ABL. Now we can try to build the firmware again. Success! And as you can see, our printer has a new name. Now, you need to load the changed values from our firmware and save it back to EEPROM memory. The firmware has been modified, so let's change settings in our slicer. In our slicer, we find the start G-code section. Inside, we look for the G28 alias command for homing. Let's see if we have the M190 command before or after G28. This command waits for the print bed to reach the target temperature. In previous videos, we talked about a thermal expansion of materials. The print bed is at risk of being bent during heating. Therefore, the print bed needs to be heated to the temperature at which printing will take place. The calibration will then be more accurate and will accurately reflect the current state of the print bed. Under command M190 comes command G29, which starts the automatic calibration process. It is important that G29 is executed after G28. Because of the type of our calibration sensor, we insert a line before G28 with a command waiting to confirm that our calibration sensor is inserted in the holder. We can do this with a command M0 insert Z switch. And the same needs to be done after the auto calibration. Here you have to remove our calibration sensor from the holder. We do this by adding a command M0 remove Z switch under G28. We write this data without diacritics. If you have everything set, we can go to print the test object and set the first layer high. We need two things to tune the first layer. Sheet of paper, as in the case of manual calibration and mesh bed leveling. And of course, the model on which we test the first layer. As a model we can use a simple cross or a simple object covering corners and the center of the print bed. We set the high of the object according to the high of our first layer. Thanks to this, we get a model that will contain only one layer. Insert the card into the printer, but do not start printing yet. through the menu, preheat the printer to the material from which you print most often. Clean the nozzle from residues of filament and other dirt. Insert the sensor and home the printer. After homing, remove the sensor. If our measurement was correct, we should now be close to the print bed when moving to position 0 on the Z-axis. Now we will set the actual distance of the sensor from the nozzle on the Z-axis. Open the probe Z-offset configuration and slowly move the nozzle down above the print bed. When the nozzle is close to the print bed, we grab our calibration tool and start calibrating like in a case of mesh bed leveling. With the only difference that we will calibrate only one point. After calibration, go back to the settings menu and store the changes. To verify that the settings are correct and stored, we can try tuning the printer off, on, and try to repeat the calibration process. Now it is time to start print the test file. If necessary, you can double click on the home screen to open the baby stepping menu to adjust the height of the first layer. Be sure to save these changes if you want to keep it for the future prints. Baby stepping is in our case editing probe Z offset, which we set at the beginning of the video in our firmware. This allows it to be edited directly in the printer and stored in the EEPROM or similar memory. There are several ways to get to the menu. You will always find the settings in the configuration in probe Z offset. During printing, you can also find it under Tune in the printer menu or by double-clicking on the main screen. Our calibration is complete when our print doesn't contain any gaps and it is like one solid piece. I use ultra-base coated glass on my printer. But what happens if I replace this glass, for example, for a mirror? This should not be a problem with the calibration method we have used. The same in case of an original ND3 print surface. Since the end stop is movable, our home Z position is adjusted according to the surface we touch. Thanks to this, even this glass from the photo frame should be okay. Even an adhesive tape like a print surface should behave just like any other surface. As you can see, without any change to the first layer high, Artis object looks almost identical on all print surfaces.